Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Cougars of Houston, ready to launch. Everybody's getting loose. They know what type of opportunity is in front of them if they can land a victory today. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Fred Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Texas is Robertson Stadium and the battlefield for this game. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. McCarthy has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. Smith takes it at the 4. He's to the 20. Looking for the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Some open field. He's knocked out of bounds at the 46-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Slings it. And they push him out at the 31.
That's a gain of 15 on the play. First down.
Roger. Let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Tackle made at the 31-yard line. Stop at the 33-yard line. That's a 2-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 21. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen, and he's tackled at the 27. A gain of 6.
And I thought this play was going to go for more yards, but the defense did a good job of shutting it down before the halfback could get any further downfield.
Southern Miss could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and it's long enough. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
Let's check in on some Big 12 action. And for UTEP, they remain red hot.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. They'll work the left side. He's to the 40. Here's an opening. Inside the 30. He's finally tackled at the 25-yard line. So we've got a first down after a great running play. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Touchdown, Cougars. We'll be right back. splits the uprights with the extra point. A short two-play, 73-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
The score now, 7-0. Smith fields it at the 1. Tackle made at the 22. Houston's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And down he goes, around the 33-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Straight ahead on McGinn, and there's nowhere to run. It out to about the 49.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Runs outside for a nice game. Caught out in the open. He's tackled at about the 37-yard line. From the 33-yard line, second down. And he's tackled right away.
Game 14 on the way. That makes it first and 10.
The 10. And he tackles him hard at the 9.
Gain 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
Guys, stay in situation. Let's go.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Golden Eagles.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for. An opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
Time to check in on Rustin. This game was so tight, every play seemed to be of the utmost importance.
The Bulldogs grabbed the win by 5.
All right, thanks, Reese. The Golden Eagles running back, he was injured earlier. You see him down there on the sideline, and it looks like he's ready to get back in the game. Newsom, ready to kick. He'll take it from the 2. Across the 30. The 50. Inside the 30. And he will score. And he tacks on the extra point. Houston gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 20. At the 30. They'll bring him down at the 34.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. He's taken down around the 45-yard line.
First down.
He's taken down right around the 42-yard line.
Good solid running right there. Getting past a defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
McIntyre again. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Throw out to the receiver. They'll bring him down right around the 34.
That'll bring up third and two.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That makes it first and 10.
Through one quarter, the Cougars with a touchdown lead. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Makes it to the 17.
First and goal.
Here we go, here we go. Mike 51.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
It's the 11th play of the drive. The 9-yard line. It's third down, and they come up to the line about 9 yards away from the end zone. Kicks away, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20, and he has another corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 47-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams.
In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Houston
holds a four-point lead.
Get to that quickly. Tackle made around the 41-yard line. From the 41-yard line, it's first down. Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. And they make the stop
at about the 33-yard line.
And catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
Two times.
First and 10. Ball on the 21.
Watch.
Nice gain as he works the right side.
That makes it second and 6.
The ball here and brought down in the backfield.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play. Third down.
From the 18-yard line, third down.
Ready!
Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds. Houston is up by 4.
Let's go! Red 18!
And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short game.
And this is the 8th play of the drive.
Quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
The extra point. McCarthy looks ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Pass to the tight end, but he bottles the ball away.
That is a great hit. And we're not just talking about some undersized wide receiver. This is a big guy, and you've really got to bring it to knock the ball away like he did there.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25. There's a strike complete. And down he goes at the 35.
Gain of 10 on the play. First down.
All day, dog. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53. Set. Blue 19. Blue 19.
At the 24.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
Quick pass. He's tackling
around the 29-yard line.
That'll bring up third and long.
he's taken down right around the 20. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does, and he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10.
They hand it off. They bring him down in the backfield. They come out on an empty backfield. Out of bounds at the 18. King picks up about 3 with that catch.
That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
That's the kind of rangy flanker every quarterback wants to be throwing to. He did well to make sure he had enough yardage to pick up the first down.
2-score game, and they can cut that down here if they can get this one in the end zone. Zips it to his receiver. Down.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
And he hits the PAT. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
The Blue Devils on the field at Wallace Wade Stadium in Durham. The Blue Devils hammer that running game and score a touchdown. Every punch has been counterpunched. A 21-21 tie.
21-17, our game here. Newsom gets set to kick this one away. From his own goal line. Tackle at the 29-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Houston is up 4. And he's taken down around the 34-yard line. Williams picks up around 5 yards with that catch. From their own 34-yard line. Second down. Under heavy pressure, he lets it fly. He goes up and gets it. They bring him down at the 17-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. Throws this one away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. Kicks up, and it's through the uprights. They might just want to squib this one. Only a few seconds left here before halftime. And he got all this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Oh, man. He took him down hard. There's been no lack of scoring here as we've reached halftime. Houston's lead is a touchdown.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation.
that excites. David Pollock and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit, but great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Houston is up by a touchdown.
Let's go!
Makes it to the 34. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. His way to the 49-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Here we go.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. From the 34-yard line, second down. And they get nice yardage on that one. Houston is up 7. Under pressure. He gets rid of this one. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Check right, check right. 57 to the right, mark 57. Let's go! Right, 80!
He's knocked out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 17. Darts it to the left. And he's got it. Touchdown, Cougars. Splits the uprights with the extra point. McCarthy has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Smith from the 1. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 29. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. On the ground, up the middle. They'll drop in for a loss.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
Gains his way to the 36-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up 32.
He might have a chance. Makes it out to about the 50. Run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Down. Blue 42.
And he's tackled right away.
Roberts on the tackle at the 34-yard line. First down.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. And we'll take a break while the injured player is attended to.
That brings him 2nd and 5.
It's 2nd down, 5 to go. Ball on the 29. Little screen pass. Brought down around the 23-yard line.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys. Let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, good check.
Alert, Oklahoma.
He's into the open field. Tackle at the 12.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. First down.
He makes it to the 9.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
We won't
come
to my
work. Let's go.
He might have a chance. Touchdown, Golden Eagles.
By the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
And he converts the extra point. The Golden Eagles tight end down there on the sideline. He's such a key ingredient in their offense, both in the running game and the passing game. And hopefully he'll be able to get back in this ball game. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Golden Eagles have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Up the middle for a nice game. They're about 4 yards away here on 2nd down. Houston up 7 points. Caught, and that's a 1st down. Tackle made at the 43.
That's good enough for another Houston. 1st down.
Bulldogs, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. The Cougars with a touchdown lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Fires out to his receiver. Knocked out of bounds.
About the 43-yard line.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43.
The 35.
That makes it 7-2.
Two times.
Two down. Houston is up a score.
Let's go.
Big opening. He's at the 20. The 10. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. Great-looking play by the offense as the halfback took it in for the score.
Here's a play that was well-designed and well-executed. It can't get much better than that.
He makes the PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The battle for bragging rights in the Red River, Oklahoma and Texas. Here's a rivalry that is flat out nasty. Texas on top, 7-0.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another six on the board here. And down he goes, the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Gets it out in a hurry. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He wants it all, going long. Caught. Touchdown, Southern Miss.
Great effort by the wide receiver. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play.
Tacks on the extra point. So a four-play, 74-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So the score now, 38-31. Southern Miss is lining up to kick this one off. Just amazing, Herbie. We've seen four straight possessions now in which the offenses have scored. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Houston is up by a touchdown.
Let's go! Red 68! Red 68!
He's taken down at the 22.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Second and eight. Ball on the 22-yard line. First time out of the half. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Wants to throw outside. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds. He gets to 100-yard receiving with that grab.
You gotta love this quarterback-receiver combo. Talking to these guys before the game, they told me they spend about an hour after every practice perfecting the routes. It sure showed.
Gets out to around the 28.
He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
Fires out to his wideout. They'll bring him down to the 17-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 17. Just under two to go in the game. Down. Knocking on the door here. It's first and goal inside the five.
Here we go. Wide 80. Wide 80.
Score, now it's up to the defense, and they're well aware that maybe one stop and they've got a victory. And he adds the extra point. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
Three words say it all. Red River rivalry, Oklahoma and Texas. Let's take yet another peek at this game. These two teams hate each other.
Hate is such a strong word, but it really fits here.
The Longhorns have the lead, 21-7.
All right, thanks, Reese. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, somebody needs to send a memo to the defenses that it's okay to tackle somebody or stop somebody. Really good offense, really bad defense. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
Under a minute left in the game.
The spike will stop the clock.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle, and they got him for a loss, and they lose a couple there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
The stop at the 43-yard line. He's got all day. He's in trouble. Throws incomplete.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And it's almost picked off. And once again, the coach has decided to go for it on fourth down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He rifles it to the left. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Houston staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happy.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.